coming up.
We can get off the building and sit down somewhere. Right there in front of you.
Not the old show.
No, this off the bill too.
Well, this is bad.
Well, good morning. Glad you're here. As you can tell, I am not Patrick Ken. He looks a lot better than I do.
Y'all have about the same amount of hair there.
Nobody asked him to testify. All right. A couple of announcements as we get started. Good to see Mr. Henry Starnes over here this morning. Good to see you out and doing better.
Hey.
Is that any better?
It says it's on.
It says it's on.
It's not.
Well, I'll talk louder.
But it's good to see.
You can edit all this out, can't you?
Good to see Mr. Henry here this morning. Glad to see you out and about and doing better. That's a huge praise report right there. Pastor Ken is not here, as you can see. He is still recouping. I'm not 100% sure, so I don't want to misstate, but that crazy bug that has gone around, maybe kind of playing its way around the house at the parsonage. So certainly keep that whole family in prayer. With any kind of sickness at all, when you get in the house, it likes to bounce from one person to the next person to the next person. So certainly keep Pastor Ken and Leslie and Jack in prayer. And Jack, I know you will probably see this, and for those of y'all that don't know, this is truly me and Jack thing. Jack, buddy, you are the man, the myth, and the legend. That's a me and Jack thing. We communicate that every week. But certainly we love them. Pastor Boss is going to be sharing a message with us later on via the video up here, and we're very thankful for him. And it's a good message that you're going to get to hear this morning from him. If you have not picked up your 2021 church directory, see Vinny at the end of church back in the classroom, and she'll get that for you. I don't know if someone is trying to communicate something to me or not, but after early service, a wedding ring was brought up to me and an earring that had been lost or left in here. If you know of anyone that's missing them, please, I'll give these to Vinny and she'll hold on to these. But please, they're beautiful. And I don't know what the hidden message in that is, but if anybody's lost that, please let them know. Other announcements. When we do get to the offering, Ms. Braille is going to come up and sing a very beautiful song for us. Super awesome to see our young people involved in singing, so that'll be a very special moment that I'm looking forward to as well. With that being mind, said, let's get our hearts ready for worship with a prayer. Thank you. So that, what she just prayed was straight scripture. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. And what better way to start our hearts in worship is to look at God's word. And if we read responsibly Psalm 67. May God be merciful to us and bless us. Let your ways be made known upon the earth. Let the peoples praise you, O God. Let the nations be glad and sing for joy. Let the peoples praise you, O God. The earth has brought forth her increase. May God give us his blessing.
And may all the ends of the earth stand in awe of him.
Please stand for our first hymn that is actually printed in your bulletin. Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
You may be seated. The second psalm that we're going to look at today, you're going to read for me, Miss Rowe. Thank you.
Is that okay with you, man?
Go for it.
As Eddie was saying, let's again read responsibly Psalm 50 as printed in your bulletin. The Lord, the God of gods, has spoken.
He has called the earth from the rising of the sun to the setting.
Out of Zion, perfect in its beauty,
God reveals himself more.
keep silence. Before him there is a consuming flame, and around about him a raging storm. He calls the heavens and the earth from above to witness the judgment of his people. Gather before me my loyal followers, those who have made a covenant with me and sealed it with sacrifice. Let the heavens declare the rightness of his cause. God himself is judge. Here ends the reading of the Psalms. The New Testament reading comes from 1 Timothy, the 4th chapter. Now the Spirit expressly says that in later times some will depart from the faith by devoting themselves to deceitful spirits and teachings of demons through the insincerity of liars who consciences are seared, who forbid marriage and require abstinence from foods that God created to be received with thanksgiving by those who believe and know the truth. For everything created by God is good, and nothing is to be rejected if it is received with thanksgiving, for it is made holy by the word of God in prayer. If you put these things before the brothers, you will be a good servant of Christ Jesus, being trained in the words of the faith and of the good doctrine that you have followed. Have nothing to do with irreverent silliness. Rather, train yourselves for godliness. For while bodily training is of some value, godliness is of value in every way, as it holds promise for the present life and also for the life to come. The saying is trustworthy and deserving of full acceptance. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Good morning and welcome to our worship service today. It's good to be with you again. Mitchie and I are looking forward to the time when we can come back and be with you regularly for our worship on Sundays. We also keep in our hearts and our prayers Pastor Ken and Leslie, and pray that they will continue to get stronger and feel better day by day. Our gospel lesson for today is written from the 9th chapter of the Gospel of St. Mark, beginning at the 2nd verse. After 6 days, Jesus took with him Peter, James, and John, and led them up on a high mountain by themselves. And he was transfigured before them, and his clothes became radiant, intensely white, as no one on earth could bleach them. And there appeared to them Elijah with Moses, and they were talking with Jesus. And Peter said to Jesus, "Rabbi, it is good that we are here. Let us make 3 tents, one for you and one for Moses and one for Elijah." For he did not know what to say, for they were terrified. And a cloud overshadowed them, and a voice came out of the cloud, "This is my beloved Son. Listen to him." And suddenly, looking around, they no longer saw anyone with them but Jesus only. And as they were coming down the mountain, he charged them to tell no one what they had seen until the Son of Man had risen from the dead. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. One time there was a church that was gathering funds to build a fellowship building. And the pastor announced in the church, "If anyone would give to our fund $1,000, then you can select the 3 hymns today." And no one in the church, everyone was quiet. And then back in the far corner, there was this older lady, and she's waved her hand and said, "I will accept that." And the pastor was so excited. "Oh, yes, that's wonderful." And the lady said, "I'm glad to help out the church." And the pastor asked, "Well, what hymn do you want?" And the lady looked around all over the church and said, "I want him and him and him. Jesus took three disciples with him upon the mountain of transfiguration. In our gospel lesson, we see a special time for the three disciples, Peter, James, and John, on the mountain with Jesus. This is a special moment when the very body of Christ is changed and his clothes become dazzling white. The gospel says no one on earth could bleach the clothes so white. It was a special time of called transfiguration when Jesus is blessed with the body of heaven that shows his glory and his beauty as the Savior. The three disciples were in awe of that Jesus moment. One time a family was going to go to an art museum, and they took their little son, he was 6 years old, and when they got into the building, the mother said, "Now, you sit here and don't break anything." So the little boy had to sit on the bench, and his little legs were so short, he could not even touch the floor, so his legs just dangled in the air, and he had nothing to do. And then a soldier walked past and saw him and came over and sat down beside him, and the two became instant friends, and they laughed and enjoyed playing together, and they attacked the evil monsters, and they defeated all of the bad monsters. Together they had a special time, a special place, and a special moment. Jesus called his three disciples together on that mountain of transfiguration, and he shared with the three a special time, a special moment, a special place of blessing, for they too could see the glory of heaven come down upon Jesus' body. Jesus shines on the mountain. His glory is so clear. And then Jesus receives a blessing from heaven. The words, a voice announces, "This is my beloved Son. Listen to him." A blessing comes down on Jesus with the shining of his clothes and the glory of his body. The words of blessing is upon Jesus that now truly, truly, he is anointed as the Son of God. Clearly. And the disciples hear those words, and they hear the words, "Listen to him." So truly now they follow Jesus even more closely because they have been told by the Heavenly Father, "Listen to my beloved Son." Now on that mountain, you would think it would be a place of joy. But reading the gospel lesson, the writer tells us the disciples were terrified. They were terrified because they knew they were in a holy place that only God could lead them through. And so they were afraid. And Peter, you know, Peter's always talking. He's always talking. So he said, "Lord, let us build three tents, one for you one for Moses and one for Elijah. He did not know what he was saying. He was terrified. But Jesus blesses the disciples. And with us, there are times in our faith too when we see God in his holiness and we feel him so close to us that we may be afraid also, like those three disciples. But know that Jesus has called us to be close to him as his disciples. We know this is the way of being a friend of God, being close. One time a church was holding a conference on the weekend, and there was a group of people together in a circle, and they were discussing their beliefs. And one woman asked another woman, "Are you a woman of great faith?" And the other woman says, "No, I am a woman of little faith in a great God." And that is our way also with those disciples. We are people of little faith in a great and glorious God. Jesus then leads his disciples down off the mountain and back into the world of his ministry day by day. And Jesus, as they're walking down the mountain, tells the disciples, "Tell no one what you have seen. Tell no one until the Son of Man rises from the dead." It is not the time, Jesus tells his disciples, to tell all the people of the glory of the heavenly life, the glory of the Son of God. Jesus can feel the shadow of the cross getting closer and closer. Jesus knows that he must go through the way of the cross before he rises from the dead. He will suffer, he will experience great pain, and the cross will lift him up over the earth. But it is a cross, even so, of glory, for the glory that Jesus experienced on that day on the mountain remained in his life. He is the Son of glory for us always, always. And Mount Calvary is a place of glory, a place of pain, yes, but always remember, Jesus accepted the cross for us, for our salvation, and the place of the cross is a place of glory. Once there was a scientist named James Simpson, and he discovered many, many wonderful scientific experiments. And one day he was asked, "What is your greatest scientific discovery?" And the scientist thought and thought a moment. And then he said, "My greatest discovery is that I am a sinner and I have a great God, Jesus Christ." What a wonderful confession of faith. And you and I, we also can share that belief. We are sinners, yes, but we possess a beautiful, magnificent Savior, Jesus, who has come to our world and has accepted the cross as a place of his glory on earth. Jesus leads us onward. From the Transfiguration Mountain, he leads us on out into the world today. Jesus said, "The Son of Man shall rise from the dead." That is a promise that we hold on to. And as we go through the way of the cross, we know that the final place for Christians is a place of glory, is a place of victory. It is a place where Jesus, risen from the dead, now invites us to share with him this victory of life over death. For us, Jesus is a glorious Savior, and in the cross we receive the blessing of life forever. For we know he shall rise from the dead. One time there was a stranger driving through one of the great cities, and he got in the middle of the city and he was just lost. He could not find his way back out to the big road that would lead him home. And he searched and searched and he just could not find his way. Then he noticed on the corner over there a police car, and he stopped and asked the policeman, "Please, can you help me? I cannot find the right road." Policeman said, "Oh, that's easy." He began to tell the man, "Well, you go this way and you turn left and you go three blocks and you turn right." And the man's eyes just started popping, confused. And the policeman knew that he would never find his way. And he said, "Don't worry, my friend. You only follow me and I will lead you out to the main road, and you will be safe." That is the promise of our Savior, the promise of our God. We behold the beauty of our Savior shining before us day by day. And we walk with our Savior, our beautiful Lord, and he has promised us, "You will be safe. I will show you the way." And in his glory, we know we shall arrive safely. This is our King of all kings, the brilliant Savior, who is now in our lives forever. And in his name, we praise and give God our thanks. Amen. The peace of God that passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Amen. Thank you.
time of prayer, a couple things to keep in mind. Ms. Barbara Carricker is at home. Benny was saying that she actually came home. We got to report Joe's doing a little bit better, so keep him and Ms. Shirley in prayer. The one Acquire family, the John Curtin family, are families here in our communities that have lost loved ones this week. And Gary, if you and Ron will give me that, is Andrew, what is Andrew's last name? The fireman?
Bly.
We were right, Uncle. We were right. Bly, okay. The fireman, we had his service, I think, here yesterday. So keep them in prayer. Others, Pastor Cannon and Ms. Leslie and Jack. And, you know, I'm thinking about as Pastor Boss is ministering, that's one of the only trips he gets to get out right now. And, I mean, I just, in my mind, I can't grasp what that's like to have been at home since March. We're headed toward a year. I mean, I keep Pastor Boss and Ms. Fiji in our prayer. And others in our church were like that. You can't get out in any way, shape, or form. Keep them in prayer. A card is huge to people. A phone call, a text, an email. Those things are huge for people that is their only source of communication right now. So please keep all of those in prayer as well. When we think about those that are newly married, we've got Jen and Omar's son, Nathan, and daughter-in-law, Tracy, who just got married a couple of weeks ago as they start their new lives together. So we keep them in prayer. Those of you that are married, you know how to pray for newlyweds. Miss Judy's shaking her head over here. Yep. So we keep them in prayer. Let's put a word of prayer. Almighty God and Heavenly Father, you have revealed the divine purity and nature of Jesus, death and resurrection for your people. We pray that through your holy word, we may fully come to understand the breadth of your gift to us through Jesus' transfiguration. We pray that we are a church that is faithful in seeking God's truth so we may lead others to you. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Gracious God, we thank you for the instituting the covenant of marriage and the blessing of families. We pray for these gifts, and these gifts would be cherished within our households and honored in our society. And as Nathan and Tracy embark on a new journey, Lord, that your presence would be with them. That may we as Christians bear witness to your love that sustains us through Jesus Christ. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Merciful Lord, we pray for those who are in authority over us at the local, the state, and the federal levels. Pour out your blessings upon them as they administer laws for the betterment of our communities and our country. May they be people who seek wise and godly counsel. Bless our armed forces that they would also serve with honor and integrity. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, we praise your holy name and thank you for providing all we need in sickness and in health. We pray for those who are in the healing process and for those just beginning their journey to wellness, especially for Ms. Barbara, for Joe Allen, Pastor Ken, Leslie, Jack, and all those others that we name in our heart. May your Holy Spirit guide them and sustain them both now and forever. Lord, in your mercy. And into your hands, gracious God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
Amen. We confess what we believe. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to hell. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. good and loving God, we rejoice in the birth of Jesus. As you have blessed us with your gifts of grace, receive the gifts we offer to you this morning. May all the world shout for joy at the coming of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Together we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Peace and share Christ to the world.
We will. Thanks.